Hey everybody, welcome back to Teachers Tech. I'm just at day two of Google I.O. It's been an exciting amount of product information and lots of AI stuff. One thing that caught my eye was LearnLM, and I got lucky enough to catch up with Ben Gomes here, who is the Chief Technologist Sustainability at Google for Learning?
No, Learning and Sustainability.
Oh, okay, okay. And one of the things I'm curious, I'm going to ask Ben about LearnLM, but I'm really curious how you got to Google. And you kind of, I had a little talk with you yesterday about education, and I could see the passion coming out and everything. I just like for the viewers to kind of understand that a bit.
Yeah, so I joined Google a long time ago. I joined Google in 1999, and I worked on search for 20 years. But even during that time, I'd always been going back to India to where I grew up to understand more about the education system there. And I saw so much need. And so I wanted to work on education and learning. And after 20 years, I wanted to work on that. And so I decided to do it at Google because I felt like Google's tools are information tools that are also used for learning. People use YouTube for learning. People use search to learn. There's Google Classroom. There's Google Scholar, Google Arts and Culture. Because we build tools for organizing information, and a key use of information is learning, right? So I felt like by working at Google, I could work with each of those products to further the cause of learning education in those products. And then the AI revolution happened, right? And that turbocharged those efforts in all across all these different products. And you're seeing the effect of that today with like all of these announcements around learning in various different products.
So now with the one product I already mentioned was LearnLM, and it's kind of caught my attention. I liked how the release yesterday on the stage, they talked about it being in 2.5. And can you explain how that worked, kind of how the fine tuning is and where it is now and where you can kind of see it going?
So LearnLM started well over a year and a half ago, maybe, with this notion that we talk about using AI to create a tutor for a student. But what does it mean to be a good tutoring experience? And it means several things. It means, first of all, you need to be accurate. You need to follow pedagogical principles, managing cognitive load, following instructions well, and many other principles of that sort. So what the team did was break down those principles and measure how well we were doing on those different principles, and then fine-tune a model that they call LearnLM to be good on those principles and show that they could be better than our base models and better than anybody else using in an evaluation. Fast forward till today, and rather than having a separate model, they have built those learnings into the core Gemini models. So that learning and those principles are now infused into the core Gemini model, and you can evoke that with the right kind of prompting of the Gemini models. And there are like really amazing prompts that will give you like great quizzes. I've been using it myself, you know, as a kind of self-assessment on things that I've been trying to learn myself. And so that set of capabilities, our hope is that it will enable the building of much better tools by teachers, by students, and so on, for better learning, more active learning. I think what AI brings to the table is it allows learning to become active so that you can follow your curiosity. And I think that's sort of, if you can do that, it's a driving force behind why learning can be both interesting, fun, and effective at the same time.
I'm excited when I think about the idea of LearnLM even differentiating for students when it's the, you know, they give one input and it kind of meets the student where they're at. And you mentioned a tutor, like a personal tutor. Do you see that becoming a growing thing in the future where each, like I have 12-year-old twins and I'm excited as they go through, will they have this way to check their knowledge, you know, and learn where it meets them at?
Exactly. So we have to have a quizzing gem that we launched in Gemini, and you can evoke it by asking for a quiz. And I think it works exactly like that to like begin to quiz you on what you know. That's just a starting point. But if you go into with a prompt, you can get, and we have got a whole prompt library, you can get a much more elaborate set of behaviors based on what you want for your learning process or for students at different levels of learning. And it's just going to be quite different based on, you know, at what level are they studying.
Mm-hmm. And at the same time, I think I'm excited because I think sometimes teachers fear, oh, they're going to lose, you know, they're going to lose their job or something. But I don't see that. I see it just enhancing their ability.
I think the role of the human in learning is fundamental. My mother was a teacher, and I think people learn because of other people. And I think that is really, you know, people are inspired by other people to learn. I've had I had a chemistry teacher in school who was an interesting teacher, but he inspired a generation of people to learn because you saw his passion for chemistry and that made you interested in it because he was so interested in it. And, you know, that kind of passion is what a teacher brings to the fore. That kind of understanding of the students and where they are, what their difficulties are. I think learning is a very deeply human process. And that's the role that the teacher can uniquely play. Other humans can play too. Parents can play a role there. Peers play a role there. But it is fundamentally, I think, a human process. Yeah.
Even as it goes forward past, I think when these students, if they can learn to use this technology and when they're done school, it's the lifelong learner that you're creating that you can access that at any time. And when I think about the other thing, like the Gemini Live, you put the multimodal aspect in and I just kind of blows my mind with students are just going to be talking, it's going to be seeing, it's going to be, you know, thinking about these education principles behind it. So it's quite exciting.
Yeah, it's just the starting of that journey, right? I mean, I use the example of in COVID, I became interested in plants. And I'd been interested in plants for a while, but like I could never know the names of plants because, and then with Google Lens, which is just allows you to take a picture of the plant and tell you what the plant is, I could begin to learn about plants the way that I wanted to, which is sort of the botany of plants. What are the divisions of the plant kingdom? How are they represented in the world around me? Why do all these different plants that are very different in evolution actually have a similar structure, right? So there are lots of interesting questions that I could attack my own way, and I got an abiding interest in plants, and now I have a fair number of them since that period of time, and it's opened up a whole new part of the world for me that I had always ignored before.
It's built the curiosity, creativity.
It took a little germ of curiosity in me and allowed it to be amplified.
Yes. Well, that's exciting. You know, thank you so much for taking the time and discussing this. This is something I'm really excited about. I'm excited about creating some more videos and showing people how to use LearnLM, and I'll put out those videos soon. But thank you very much, Ben. It was great talking to you.
It's a pleasure talking to you.